Hey, Mental Moss here, and welcome to the channel! And in this video, we're gonna talk about Arms Race. Arms Race is a new standalone game mode for Borderlands 3. It's a roguelike experience with gameplay mechanics that you recognize from Battle Royale games. It's not a true Battle Royale mode, so you won't be fighting against other players. It's still Borderlands, it's still a co-op experience. Arms Race will drop you and your buddies onto a map filled with enemies just like the base game. However, because this is a separate experience, you will be stripped from all your gear, skill tree and guardian rank. Don't worry, your gear will be saved, you just don't have access to it. Arms Race is a game show hosted by Axton and Salvador. They are two fan favorite characters returning from Borderlands 2 and they will provide commentary during this 20 to 25 minute event. Why Axton and Salvador? Well, their cash flow isn't all that great at the moment, so why not host a game show? You know, Salvador still has to pay off that tab in DLC 2. So how do you play Arms Race? You will drop into the map and there you will always find a white starter chest. This will always have two shields and two weapons. So now that you are good to go, it's your goal to find better loot and stay alive. The staying alive part is very important in this mode because, you know, it's one life challenge. So you want to make your way to one of those red chest locations that are marked on the map, because this is where you can get the good stuff. But the game isn't gonna make it easy for you, because you only have limited time to get there. Because when you look at the map, you can see these circles. This is your playing ground, and as time progresses, those circles will shrink and force you to the center of the map. There you will face off against a boss, and you want to collect quality gear in order to do so. Because if you die, you will lose all your gear. Like I mentioned before, it's still a one life challenge. But don't worry, you got these doll extractors throughout the map. And there's even one after the boss fight. With these extractors, you will be able to send a limited amount of gear back to the main game. In Arms Race, you will be able to find over 20 new pieces of gear, which include the new class mods for the new skill trees. Throughout your play session, you want to collect as much gear as you can, because 1. You're looking for good gear, and 2. You can use those items to sell at vending machines, as these also have a good chance of providing quality gear. But hey, it's still Borderlands, I even found a legendary from a trash pile. And while we dismiss certain legendaries in the main game because they aren't really performing, you should really give them a try in Arms Race, because 1. You don't have anything else, and 2. Some of these weapons do really wreck in this mode. Personally, I had a lot of fun with Arms Race. Normally I don't do these one life challenges, but there is something to this high risk, high reward gameplay style. I did have to adjust my playstyle, as I normally take my time to compare stats and look at all the weapons, and you don't always have the time to do that. As I have been exclusively been using the top tier legendary weapons in the main game, I needed to rediscover the weapon rarities again. You do really want to go for those points of interest, as taking out a Spider Queen isn't always worth your time. The chance of you getting a powerful item isn't that significant, and therefore you can better keep moving, because as mentioned before, you don't have all the time in the world, as the storm will consume the map and you can't survive in it. You won't die instantly, but you will take damage over time. I kinda missed my action skill, as this is a character and game defining feature of Borderlands, but the developers mentioned they really wanted to give meaning to the weapons. And I get that, and I see how it works in the game mode. But I think that skill trees is one of those things that makes Borderlands, Borderlands. Another thing that I missed was speed. Mostly because I play Zane, and he has a lot of speedboats. And since you don't have access to your skill tree, yeah, it felt kinda slow at first. Getting a snowdrift artifact during your run is awesome, because you can quickly go all over the place. It really helps you farm those red chests. Arms Race is an exciting game mode because you only have one life and you can lose all your gear when you die. This really raises the lava. Stakes.
The lava's rising!
As you don't want to lose those new legendary items. Planning your route is important because you might want to send that item home before you drop in the final boss. While I managed to defeat the boss each time, there were some really close calls. Arms Race is part of the Designer's Cut. This fifth DLC package is included in Season Pass 2, but you can also purchase it individually. The Designer's Cut contains Arms Race and the additional skill trees for each of the Vault Hunters. And it releases on November 9th. If you want to watch a full play session of me playing Arms Race, you can check out the video that's up on screen now. And then you can see me jump scaredly up and down at the boss fight because I forgot I equipped the rectifier and I thought the boss was stuck in dealing shock damage. So have fun watching that, and thank you for watching. Bye.